हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू AVLSI लेक्चर नंबर 32 पार्ट 2। इन टुडेस टॉपिक वी विल कंटिन्यू आवर डिस्कशन ऑन कॉमन मोड रिस्पांस ऑफ असिमेट्रिक डिफरेंशियल पेयर बट विद ट्रांजिस्टर्स मिसमैच, दैट इज M1 एंड M2 आर नॉट मैच्ड परफेक्टली। सो दिस इज द कॉमन मोड रिस्पांस ऑफ असिमेट्रिक डिफरेंशियल पेयर विद ट्रांजिस्टर्स मिसमैच सर्किट डायग्राम। सो हियर व्हाट वी अज्यूम ओवर हियर इज दैट the transistors M1 and M2 are not matched. What's the meaning of that? Their W/L ratios are different and their threshold voltage is also not same. Other than that, the circuit is symmetric, the resistors are matching, and we have applied a common mode input to both the gate terminals of M1 and M2. So owing to the dimensions and the threshold mismatch, the two transistors M1 and M2 may carry slightly different current. ID1 and ID2 are not equal this time, and they may exhibit unequal transconductance, that is GM1 and GM2 are also not same. So otherwise the circuit is symmetric with RD1, RD2 is equal to RD. So over here we say that ID1 is equal to not equal to ID2 and GM1 is not equal to GM2. Assume that lambda and the body effect is ignored over here. So we have to calculate the small signal gain from the input common mode voltage to X and Y. Okay, that is, we'll study the asymmetry resulting from the mismatches between M1 and M2. So let's just draw, we have drawn the simplified version of it, connected the two gate terminals of M1 and M2 together to input common mode voltage. Now, we know that gate voltage of M1 and M2 is VG1 and VG2. It's equal to Vin of CM, right? VS1 and VS2 will be same common voltage, which will be equal to VP. Now we know that when we draw the small signal equivalent model of a transistor, we are attempting to linearize a nonlinear MOSFET, right? So Ohm's law will be applicable in a linear MOSFET, linearized MOSFET. So I will be ID1 and ID2. V will be voltage difference between gate and source, and R will be the resistance offered between gate and source. Here is a very tiny small signal model which we have drawn over here. So we between the gate and source, we have open circuit, correct? Because IG is zero. Between the drain and the source, we have GM into VGS. So ID will be GM into VGS. And what is VGS? VG minus VS. So we can write ID1 is equal to GM1 into VGS1, where VGS1 is VG1 minus VS1. VG1 is Vin of CM. And VS1 is VP. So we get the formula number one, that is 32.4.1. ID1 will be GM1 into Vin of CM minus VP. Similarly, ID2 will be GM2 into VGS2. So GM2 into VG2 minus VS2. VG2 is Vin of CM and VP is VS2. Okay. And we also know that your ID1 plus ID2 will be equal to ISS. So now the node voltage VP can be written as ISS into RSS. Very simple, correct? Now ISS is nothing but ID1 plus ID2. So VP voltage will be ID1 plus ID2 into RSS. And what is ID1 and ID2? ID1 is GM1 into Vin of CM minus VP. And ID2 is GM2 into Vin of CM in minus VP. So here we take the common term Vin of CM minus VP. And we have GM1 plus GM2 because we are adding ID1 and ID2, and common we have RSS. Okay. So the equation becomes VP is equal to GM1 plus GM2. We have separating out the terms, opening the bracket and separating out. So we'll get GM1 plus GM2 into RSS into Vin of CM minus GM1 plus GM2 into RSS into VP. Correct. Now we collect the terms of VP together. So VP will be VP into 1 plus GM1 plus GM2 into RSS is equal to GM1 plus GM2 into RSS into Vin of CM. So what will be my voltage at node P? It will be given by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS divided by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS plus 1 and that into Vin of CM. Okay, so we found out the relay equation for VP in terms of input common mode voltage given by the equation 32.4.4. Okay, so let's get back to the finding out the output differential value. I mean the output value, node value at Vx and Vy. So here, what do we do is, this is my node X and Y. So we are going to find Vx and Vy now. Okay, so we know that we are finding the small signal voltage gain. So for small signal, your supply voltage will be grounded. So VDD will be grounded. And over here, we have Vx. If you measure Vx, it will be minus RD into ID1. Why minus? Because current is entering, not leaving the ground node. So for small signal analysis, your VDD is reactivated. Hence, it is replaced by a short circuit. Correct? So Vx will be minus ID1 into RD. And we know what is ID1. Your ID1 from above will be GM1 into Vin of CM minus VP. Okay. So here it is ID2 and ID1. ID1 will be GM1 into Vin of CM minus VP. And what is VP? VP is given by this equation. So we substitute the values over here. So Vx will be equal to minus GM1 into Vin of CM minus this expression of VP into RD. So if you simplify it further algebraically, you will get Vx is equal to minus GM1. I leave up to you to exercise. You will get minus GM1 into RD into Vin of CM divided by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS plus 1. So we call this expression as 32.4.5. Similarly, your Vy will be equal to ID2 minus ID2 into RD. Similarly, right? So exactly in the same manner, your Vy will be, instead of GM1, will have GM2. Rest, all the expressions are same. So it will be minus GM2 into RD into Vin of CM, CM divided by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS plus 1. So now we have Vx and Vy. We just have to subtract that and calculate the voltage gain. So the differential component at the output will be given by Vx minus Vy. So if we subtract Vx minus Vy, the only different term will be GM1 and GM2. So that will get subtracted. So Vx minus Vy will be minus of GM1 minus GM2 into RD into Vin of CM, CM divided by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS plus 1. So next, this is a very, very important relation. Please note it down. Next, what do we call it is, we call GM1 minus GM2 difference as delta GM. Okay, that's just a notation. So now, my differential component at the output, that is Vx minus Vy divided by the common mode input voltage will be given by minus delta GM into RD divided by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS plus 1. So what is this Vx minus Vy upon Vin of CM? It is nothing but A CM dash DM. So what does it mean? It's a common mode to differential mode voltage gain. Okay, it's a common mode to differential mode voltage gain. Why? Because output is a differential mode and input is a common mode. So that's why we write it as ACM DM. Okay, in other words, the circuit converts the input common mode variation to a differential error by a factor equal to this. Okay, so ACM DM will be equal to minus delta GM into RD divided by GM1 plus GM2 into RSS plus 1. And this, mind you, this derivation is only due to DM mismatch, or we can call it as a transistor mismatch. Due to transistor mismatch, DM of both the transistors are different. That's why we get this. And we can come back to this, ideally we want ACM to be zero. Okay, so if we have symmetric transistors, equally matched transistors, that means GM1 will be equal to GM2. In the ideal case, we want the common mode voltage gain will be zero. And it will be zero whenever GM1 and GM2 are equal, as you can see, which is the desired result of a differential pair. That is, it should reject the common mode signal. But right now, due to transistor mismatch, we are getting this common mode to differential mode conversion. I hope it is clear. So we have completed the first section. Now let's go to the next one. So now let's define, now that we know the the differential mode gain and the common mode gain, let's define a metric, CMRR. So CMRR is the common mode rejection ratio. So basically, a CMRR is your measure of your differential amplifier, how good a differential amplifier depends upon the high value of CMRR, correct? So CMRR is the ability of differential amplifier to amplify the difference between the two signals and reject any common mode signal. In the general definition, we call it as a ratio of desired gain divided by the undesired gain. So desired gain is ADM, DM, that means differential signals resulting in differential mode output, and divided by ACM, DM. So that means common mode input resulting in a differential mode output. So the CMRR earlier, which you have studied in discrete circuits, was different. It was just a differential mode up to common mode. Here it is ADM, DM divided by ACM, DM. Okay. So now if only DM mismatch is considered. If only DM mismatch is considered, that is GM1 is not equal to GM2, then it can be showed that we have not proved it out. We have only discussed the response of the output due to common mode input. Now, if it is a differential mode input, we can write ADM, DM mod of that will be given by RD by 2 into GM1 plus GM2 plus 4 times GM1, GM2 into RSS, the whole divided by 1 plus GM1 plus GM2 into RSS. So this we have not derived it, but in case of a GM mismatch, this is the formula. Okay, differential in output with respect to differential input, ADM, DM. So ADM, DM is the differential mode gain. Now, we know the formula for ACM, DM for a transistor mismatch. And we just now have seen the formula for ADM, DM. So we, divide them both. Some terms get cancelled out. 1 plus GM1 plus GM2 into RSS get cancelled out. RD and RD also gets cancelled out. So what is the CMRR formula? Only due to GM mismatch, it is given by GM1 plus GM2 plus 4 times GM1, GM2 into RSS divided by twice delta GM, where delta GM is GM1 minus GM2. Okay, so this is the CMRR formula. If you want to calculate it in dB, you multiply it by 20 log to the base 10 of that value. Okay, now we have seen the formula for CMRR due to GM mismatch. Now let's see what will happen if the resistor mismatches. So here is the circuit, right, where the resistors are not the same. So the circuit is not symmetric. Here we have the effect of common mode noise in presence of resistor mismatch. So here in this case, if a resistor mismatches, then my ADM, DM, that is my differential mode gain, will be minus GM into RD. Very plain and simple, right? But my ACM, DM will be GM divided by 1 plus twice GM RSS into RD minus of GM plus twice GM RSS into RD plus delta RD. Here we got it from the previous result. Previously, in the previous lecture, we have seen this before. Due to the resistor mismatch, let's see it again. Yeah, this is the formula due to resistor mismatch. Okay, so this formula we are using it over here today. Okay, the second part of the video 32.2. Yeah, so ACM DM will be minus of GM divided by 1 plus twice DM RSS, correct. And your RD and RD will get cancelled out and you will get delta RD. So ACM, DM, that is your common mode to differential mode conversion due to resistor mismatch will be given by 32.4.11. Okay. And then the CMRR will be very easy to calculate. CMRR will be ADM, DM divided by ACM, DM. So your GM, DM will get cancelled and CMRR now will be 1 plus twice GM into RSS into RD divided by delta RD. Okay, so this is the CMRR formula due to resistor mismatch. It's very important to note it down. Many numericals can be asked based on this. So this was the CMRR formula due to resistor mismatch. Earlier one, we have derived it due to GM mismatch. So both the formulas are important. Now, there is something called as signal to noise ratio, SNR. So you should know its definition. So SNR will be equal to mathematical definition, it will be ADM DM into Vin of DM, that is Vin of DM means it's a differential input signal, the whole square divided by ACM DM into Vin of CM. Okay, so the whole square. So it's very handy to know this formula. Sometimes they ask you in the numerical. So kindly note it down or you can take a print screen of this. Yeah. So with this, we have come to the end of today's topic. We have discussed the asymmetries in the form of transistor M1 and M2 being not symmetric. And we have found out derived the formula for ACM DM, correct? Due to common mode input, we were getting a differential output. So we got that formula. And we have defined the CMRR. And we have written the formula for CMRR due to DM mismatch and also due to a resistor mismatch, okay, in both the cases. And finally, we have defined the signal to noise ratio, fine? So that's all for this session, I guess. Next time, we will solve a numerical on, common mode response of a differential pair and find out the CMRR and signal to noise ratio. So until then, have a good day and thank you.